Now, you know that saying that the grass is always greener on the other side?
Because it is. City folks say it all the time when they're in traffic and they think about living in the provinces. The grass is actually greener.
That's right. Anyway, it turns out that the grass, well, it can be longer too, and that is not always a good thing. Garth explains.
How we care for our dead says a lot about how we care for pretty much everyone. According to Rob De Lacey, we're doing pretty lousy by his whānau.
I just get so disappointed because it looks such a bloody mess.
He's talking about the grass, not just any grass, the long grass at the graveside here at the family plots in Auckland's Manukau Memorial Gardens.
So who's Millie?
Millie's my late wife. She died from an asthma attack back in 93.
Oh.
My son and his mum were very close and he decided to take his own life in 97.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, my mum and mother-in-law both died of natural causes in their 80s, but we've sort of kept them all together, as you do.
Ever since, Rob has come here regularly, never more than 6 weeks pass without a visit.
Normally it's sort of a dual-purpose mission, to visit the family and mow the lawn.
Yeah, hardly resting in peace, is it? Rob's mowing missions do keep him close to his loved ones. But he spends much of the time fuming at Auckland Council, which owns the cemetery. Rob can only recall one time in the last 25 years that he was able to leave the mower in the car.
I rang them to compliment them and ask them whether they'd got rid of some slacking staff members or what had happened. But it took me 30 minutes to get through. I was cut off twice, and by the time I'd actually got through to them, I wasn't quite so pleased as I was when I'd originally seen it.
That's another problem. Rob has lost count of the times he's complained, called, sent photos like these of the state of it, Owareake, to no avail. So after 25 years, he called fair go. The day before we visited, the mowers had come, cut, and stopped short of the row yet again.
I would say that the getting behind a hand mower is just too much for them.
And it might be getting a bit much for Rob. He's getting on, as they say.
I'm also awaiting a knee replacement, and it's a little bit of a struggle at the moment at times.
Millie's photo hasn't aged a day, and Zane's hard hat still pays tribute to a young man lost in his prime.
I mean, when I'm angry, I think to myself, well, these people are treated as second-class citizens even after passing. But in reality, I think it's just a case of the belief that these people won't complain.
Millie, Zane and Nana Eva were new Ian, laid to rest in what's called the decorated section. It's not an easy place to mow. It's an area popular with Pacifica families because, in this part, the rules allow them to really make a statement and spend time, some, every day. I've never seen so many chairs sitting ready in a cemetery.
You can see the passion and energy with which people have decorated these gravestones, celebrating their culture as well as their loved ones. And it's great that they can do that. Great the council lets them, but it doesn't let the council off the hook from its obligation to keep this place tidy.
Because it's not just a matter of basic respect. This is a classic Consumer Guarantee Act no-no as well. A service like groundskeeping must be carried out with reasonable care and skill, like it has been right through the rest of the memorial gardens.
It's not really my job. I mean, we pay for perpetual maintenance. Where is it? The rest of the cemetery gets it. I want it.
Fair to say Rob is one of those guys who thinks it's always time to mow, but he has been told there's a standard, around 140 millimetres, for how long they let the grass get at Auckland Council cemeteries, a standard that only he has been upholding. But a few weeks on, that's about to change. That's the head of cemetery services for our biggest city, coming to pay his respects to Rob.
Yeah, I'd like to apologise on behalf of my colleagues and Auckland Council. Clearly, we haven't got it right in this case, and so I just want to give you my heartfelt apology and give you an assurance that moving forward, we'll make sure that we'll be maintaining this to an appropriate standard.
OK, well, going forward, if it keeps it to an acceptable standard, that's fine, you know. We can just stick to that plan, all good.
Thank you very much.
I'll stop ringing and taking photos, etc.
Thank you.
OK, mate, thanks very much.
Mark Miller's only had the job 6 weeks, so most of this is news to him. But he's not come with excuses.
But we got it wrong, and I'm just really pleased to be able to speak to Mr. Lacey and confirm that we'll get it right moving forward.
Rob had complained a number of times using all the channels that had come to nothing, really. Why is it going to be different this time?
It's difficult for me to comment on such a long-standing problem. It does give us an opportunity to look at our processes around complaints and making sure that we're tracking them and recording them properly. So, yeah.
Consider this one,
closed.
Hey, Gar, thanks very much for your involvement. I have confidence that things are going to improve from here on. He's new in his position.
What do you think Millie will make of this?
Well, yeah, no, I'm sure she'll be pleased. She always appreciated a nice tidy garden and a closely mowed lawn.
Married the right man there, didn't she?
Yeah. Yeah, that's something I'm pretty good at, mowing lawns.
Oh, what a good man.
Good dude, good dude. What an awesome result. Mihara, well done, gentlemen. That wraps up our cemetery coverage just for tonight. Mark from the council does want to say, though, he doesn't think it's a widespread problem, Mark from the council, but if you know differently, please let us know.